Hi, I'm Cole Costello with yet another week of the NM Athletics Update. This week we saw several great performances, one team clinch a playoff berth, and another team get a win as they continue a battle to the end for the playoff spot. All that and more is coming up in this week's episode of the North Marion Athletics Weekly Update. Week 9 of the North Marion Athletics Update. The fall sports season is beginning to come to a close, but with that comes many important games, some close playoff races, and all-around intense athletics action for all of our sports. To add to the excitement, this week was the annual Pink Out Week in North Marion, so we will share the success of all the events surrounding Pink Out. The football team took on Estacada this Friday night, so we bring in our football analyst Josh Hauser to detail what happened Friday night. Josh?
Thanks, Cole. The team was optimistic all week, as along with the Rangers came an ugly 0-7 record. The Huskies' slightly better 1-6 record set up what would be an even matchup. Prior to the game, all the seniors were introduced. Here's a quick clip of each of the football team's seniors being introduced before kickoff.
And Jaden Davis, his position wide receiver, running back, and defensive back. All-around great guy. Give it up for Kyle Martin, number 82. Wide receiver, linebacker, and safety, Kyle Martin. Here he is, Zach, the Pac-Man, Packham, number 33, running back and linebacker. Here is our next senior, Hayden Pyatt. His position, slot, receiver, and safety. Here is Ryan Steele, Rhino. Position, offensive tackle and defensive tackle. And then there's the water boy on top of that. Put your hands together for Jake Johnson. His position is lineman. Here he is. Football is his game, and Nathan Oliver is his name. Bring him out. His position, linebacker and left tackle. Here he is, number 11, Jeremy Parkinson. Bones. Quarterback and cornerback were his positions. Here he is, the big guy, Tanner Shrink. His position, right guard and nose guard. Last but not least, his name ends with W. Give it up for Zach Williamson. His position, wide receiver, slot receiver, and outside linebacker. You'll see number 6 in all the plays tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, one big round of applause for our seniors!
In all, it was a good evening to honor our hardworking seniors, and their leadership, poise, positive attitude, and strong effort will be greatly missed next season. As you can see, the football team honored Pink Out by dressing accordingly, including pink socks, wristbands, tape, and more. The Huskies' pass-heavy offense carried the team down the field until Estacada made a big defensive play to stop the Huskies in their tracks. After a couple of first downs, North Marion's defense came up with the stop, forcing Estacada to punt after facing a 4th-and-17. Wyatt Moore and the Huskies' passing attack picked up right where they left off, as once again they drove down the field. The Rangers' defense again stepped up, forcing a turnover as the Huskies were threatening to score. Estacada used a few big runs to march down the field and score the first points of the game. After forcing a North Marion 3 and out, Estacada scored again, taking a commanding 12-0 lead. The Huskies fought back as they drove the ball deep into Rangers territory yet again, but came up empty-handed as they could not convert a 4th down play inside the 10-yard line. Into the half, the Rangers took a 12-0 lead. Falling behind 20-0 early in the 3rd quarter, Huskies took their first drive of the second half right down the field for the score, capped off by a 15-yard touchdown from Wyatt Moore to Kyle Martin. This scoring play was set up by a 38-yard pass earlier in the drive to Zach Williamson. Sadly, that drive would be the only scoring drive for North Marion of the night, as Estacada picked up their first win of the season, grinding out a 20-7 win over North Marion. As has been the case all season, the Huskies, behind Wyatt Moore in the strong receiving corps, dominated the passing game. However, Estacada dominated the rushing game. North Marion racked up 300 yards passing, completing 23 passes. In retrospect, Estacada had a measly 8 passing yards, completing just 2 passes. The ground game was a whole different story, as North Marion could only muster 21 rushing yards. The Rangers piled on 336 rushing yards. Another key stat to show the vast difference between the two offenses was the first down statistics. Huskies had 17 first downs, 16 of which came through the air. Rangers had 19 first downs, 17 of which came on the ground. The two offensive styles were completely different, and in this case, the Rangers were able to benefit. Estacada had trouble holding on to the ball as they fumbled it four times. The Huskies finish out the regular season with a long road trip this Friday, which you'll hear all the details of and more upcoming events. That's it for our football wrap-up. Time to hand it back over to Cole.
Thanks for the summary, Josh. It was a disappointing loss for the Huskies, but good teams, instead of hanging their heads, take what they learn and build upon it, and that is what Coach Crumley and the rest of the coaching staff will continue to do. Now we'll head over to cross country, where the team competed in their last meet of the regular season. This Wednesday, the Huskies Cross Country Club competed in the Country Fair Classic. It was a flat, grass and dirt course, which consisted of three loops. It was an extremely successful run for North Marion, in that almost every runner set a personal record. The North Marion leaderboard consisted of the familiar names, Spencer Christie on the boys' side and Hannah Johnson for the girls. Spencer Christie edged out Johnny Vara by 0.4 seconds as Christie finished with a 17:44.1, and Johnny Vara finished with a 17:44.5. Hannah Johnson recorded a 22:06. The Tri-Valley District Championships are to be held this Wednesday, and we will be awaiting the exciting results from Wednesday's meet. The North Marion soccer teams each competed once this week, as both teams took on LaSalle. The Lady Huskies stayed home to host the Falcons. Defense prevailed, as it was an extremely low-scoring affair. A very aggressive game was compounded by referees with a relaxed officiating style, letting a lot of the would-be calls go. This agitated many of the Falcons supporters, who were always ready to let the ref know how they felt as he ran by. In the end, Jamie Gray's goal in the first half proved to be enough for the Huskies to steal the win as they defeated LaSalle 1-0. Taking a look at the graphic on your screen, North Marion is clinging onto a play-in spot and can seal it in a couple of wins this week. The boys' teams traveled to LaSalle to play on the turf field under the lights. LaSalle's offensive attack was outstanding as the Falcons tallied 6 goals in the Huskies. LaSalle is the strongest offensive team in the league as they are approaching an unheard of 40 goals this season, which easily ranks atop the Tri-Valley Conference. North Marion only managed 1 goal, which was scored by freshman Ivan Ramirez. Taking a look at the Tri-Valley Conference standings, North Marion sits just outside of a play-in spot and is working hard to move up and clinch a postseason chance. And probably the most exciting news of this week in North Marion Athletics was the volleyball team. Their win over Gladstone on Tuesday clinched them a playoff spot, and we are looking forward to seeing the team's postseason run. On Tuesday, Gladstone scared the Huskies by taking the first set with no problem. The tense Gym 1 crowd feared the Huskies' outlook on the game, which improved when the Huskies won set 2, edging Gladstone 25-21. From then on, the Huskies had almost no trouble flying by the Gladiators, as North Marion took sets 3 and 4 by scores of 25-13 and then 25-15. The Huskies completed the sweep of Gladstone on the season. North Marion already swept Mullala, bringing their league win total to 4. By beating these two teams twice, the Huskies are guaranteed a play-in game and potentially a playoff spot. This week, we are proud to introduce a new exciting segment, and with that, here's our very first staff athlete profile. NM Athletics' new staff athletes segment will feature a staff member from North Marion and give you a summary of their career in athletics. We hope to surprise you by showing some of your teachers in an athletic atmosphere. To kick off the series, we are starting out with arguably the most athletic and most awarded athlete, Kelly Ione. Today, Mrs. Ione can be found teaching business classes at the high school, but what you may not know is Mrs. Ione had a very successful athletic background. Kelly Ione, formerly Kelly Sorensen, attended Scappoose High School. Kelly Ione, niece Sorensen, was inducted to the Scappoose Hall of Fame in 2008. Mrs. Ione was a 4-year varsity starter in 3 sports, volleyball, basketball, and softball. She was all-league in 3 of these sports, and even all-state in basketball and softball. She was a leader on her team, and she was able to guide her team to a 4th place finish in state and was named All-Tournament and All-State her senior year. her team won the 1995 state championship in softball. With her high school career finished, she ranks as the second highest scorer in school basketball history. She finished her high school career with a 4.0 GPA. Her senior year, Mrs. Ione won the K2 Athlete of the Month for May. Moving on to her college career, Mrs. Ione was an outstanding volleyball and basketball athlete at Willamette. Twice, Mrs. Ione scored 32 points in a single basketball game. Probably the biggest accolade of her college career was being named to the NCAA Division III All-American team in basketball, and finished as the number 2 scorer there also. As you can see, Kelly had an outstanding career at Scappoose High School and Willamette University, and is an outstanding educator as well. Kelly has two sisters, Lisa and Casey, and her mom and dad are Dave and Kay Sorensen of Scappoose. She is married to the current Willamette men's basketball coach, Kip Ione, and they have two children, Lincoln and Leah. Now we leave you with some highlights from her basketball career.
Number 14, Kelly Sorensen, first quarter. Sorensen pops one from the outside, make it 5-2. Ahead to Van Dievender, put it up, blocked, and hit, rebound, Tiffany Cost. Has it stolen away, we got a loose ball. Sorensen puts it up and in. Kelly Sorensen, number 14, to Sorensen from the outside, hits the side of the backboard, gets her own rebound, puts it up and in. Try to get it inside for Cost, broken up by Sorensen. And Spalding, Sorensen on the drive, draws the foul. Leads 11-10. Sorensen's first free throw is up and down. Side for Sorensen, turns, shoots, hits. Nice job by Kelly Sorensen. By Scappoose, Spalding over to Sorensen. They score! Sorensen with the score. She's got 12 already. Sandy on the drive, block! Sorensen with the rebound, put it up and in! Sorensen around the pick, puts it up and in. Electing to take a timeout as his team falls behind. Scappoose crowd making some noise right now. Broken up by Casey Sorensen, ahead to Kelly Sorensen, number 14. She scores and she's fouled. She's got 20 in the game. Awesome night by Kelly Sorensen. The ball over to Sorensen for three. Hits! That's a big three right there, folks. Sorensen, Kelly Sorensen drives to the hoop, scores 47-42. It is good. Kelly Sorensen adding to her totals. Phenomenal player, Kelly Sorensen. The second one is down, just like the first one.
As you can see, Mrs. Ione had a very successful athletic career, earning her the title of the North Marion Athletics Staff Athlete. The second annual North Marion Athletic Hall of Fame was held Saturday night at North Marion. The event turned out to be very successful, not only bringing friends together, but recognizing several of the major athletes of the past in Husky athletics. We're going to show you a quick clip of each of the new inductees. Boyd Brown was an outstanding track and field member who threw with a missing thumb. He is currently a member of the University of Oregon Hall of Fame and a graduate of Hubbard High School. Taking the award for his late father was Boyd's son, Eric Brown. Al Barnsey was key in pushing for the girls' athletics at North Marion. The park in Hubbard is named after him and his major role in bringing female athletics not only to North Marion, but to the state of Oregon. Al's grandson accepted the award for him, as he is deceased.
We are truly honored that my grandfather, Al Barnsey, is recognized. You know, I have many memories of him, and mostly just of service. He was completely a man of service and someone who always looked for an opportunity to serve.
Keith Driver was an outstanding athlete during his time at North Marion. He was best known for his skills in basketball and football. He was a quarterback for the football team and a guard for the basketball team. Keith also played baseball and was involved with several other groups around the school.
And we were to play our final football game under the lights, and we were all excited about that. That was one of the new things for us at that time.
Ken Lambert was a four-sport athlete at North Marion. He played football, ran cross country, wrestled, and he was on the track and field team. Ken earned state championships in both cross country and wrestling.
My father, and I know he'd be very proud to accept this award. Thank you so much.
Carrie Knopp was an outstanding swimmer for the Huskies. Carrie finished high in many state championship races and put North Marion's swim program on the map.
So I do remember that first day when he made me swim breaststroke and he told me how horrible it was. But I also remember too thinking, wow, I'm loving this. I like this style. I like the people that I'm swimming with. So it just kind of got better and better from there.
Junior Sato was a successful basketball and baseball coach for North Marion. Coming to North Marion looking for just the basketball job, Junior ended up being handed the basketball and baseball positions. When all is said and done, he is better known for his baseball career than his basketball one, as he led the Huskies to the 1971 state championship and recorded over 350 wins in his coaching career.
At the top it says 1978 baseball rules. And rule number one was the coach is always right. Okay. Rule number two was if you think coach is Wong, W-O-N-G, refer back to rule number one. Open up the game against Gladstone and we jump out in the first quarter to a 20-9 lead against the number one team in the state. Horn sounds, we go over to the bench, Junior meets us and he says, remember that plan I had? And yeah, he says, we're not going to do that anymore.
I don't know what Randy did, but he should be a politician. See the facility that he has? Probably the best in the state of Oregon. Not only the best in the state of Oregon, but from what I understand, he's going to have some national recognition. I think it's about the top eight high school baseball field in the nation.
And the 1971 state championship baseball team rounded out the class of the 2011 inductions. Coach Junior Sato predicted it would be a strong season for the Huskies, and his prediction obviously turned out to be true. The Huskies clinched the Capital Conference title by defeating the Cascade Cougars. North Marion then went on to beat Junction City, who was favorite to win the title. The Huskies also destroyed Madras 11-0 during their playoff run before reaching the state championship game at what is now Geldwin Field in Portland. The Huskies, behind their pitcher Gary Hopkins, no-hit the Sherwood Bowman to take a 3-0 win and the 1971 title.
Thanks so much, you guys. I always have a lot of nice things about you. And the only reason why you ran as much as you did is because I have two outstanding coaches in high school, and I always told my players that the only way that I can thank them would be to be a good coach for you and all the other players that I coach. I always enjoy working with the ball players, and maybe looking back, I might have been a little bit too hard on them, but then on the other hand, I have to thank my coaches because they're hard on me also. So I'm not sure I understand that.
So Mark Brush has to get things going here for Sherwood, as the Huskies are only one out away from winning the AA state title here. Cliff, I might add, Hopkins has become more and more effective as this game goes along. He hasn't walked a man since the, I believe it was the second inning. Swung on him, strike one, as Mark Bush has a ripple at it. Here's a nothing one pitch. There's a ball hit to the first baseman who gloves it going away for the third out. And the North Marion fans come over the stadium wall, and the players go out to hug their pitcher Hopkins, who just pitched a no-hitter. A no-hitter for Hopkins. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left.
To sum it up, it was a great night to honor and recognize several great athletes from the school and bring old friends together. This week's FBLA High Flying Performer of the Week is Megan Crumley of the varsity volleyball team. Let's go! Megan Megan showed great composure down the stretch in the game versus Gladstone and helped them clinch a playoff spot. Her performance in that game, and including past weeks, has made her this week's FBLA High Flying Performer of the Week. And remember, you can purchase balloons from FBLA for any occasion. Just talk to Mrs. Ione about it. This week we called up Logan Beiser to ask a little about the football game on Friday. Logan, looking at the numbers, do any performances stand out at you?
Yes, actually. Wyatt Moore was 23 for 48, throwing for 300 yards and a touchdown. In the receiving category, Kyle Martin was the front runner once again. He caught 9 passes for 97 yards and the aforementioned touchdown. Kellen Pippard emerged as a reliable receiver this game, catching 6 passes for 62 yards. Hyatt, Williamson, McLaren, and Davis all had meaningful receptions for North Marion. Two Huskies were in the double digits in terms of tackles, as Matt O'Hearn continued his defensive dominance with 15 tackles, and Zach Williamson had 13.
Now, Logan, we're going to shift gears here a little bit and talk about volleyball. Could you ask about what potential opponents they might face in the play-in game?
Local? It looks like it's going to be Astoria, considering they're 19-1 and undefeated in league. Unfortunately, without playing off an upset, it doesn't look like the Huskies are going to beat their future opponent. So, most likely, we're going to have a tough challenge against Astoria.
Thank you, Logan. And with that, we'll send it over to Wyatt for more upcoming events.
Let's get right to more upcoming events. On Tuesday, boys soccer hosts Gladstone at 4 p.m. Volleyball also has a home match with Madras. It will be another pink out game, and we challenge you as Husky fans to pink out gym. It is also senior night, as the seniors will be honored for their great accomplishments. Girls soccer travels to Gladstone and will play the Gladiators also on Tuesday at 6:30. On Wednesday, the cross country team competes in the TVC District Championships. The meet is at McIver Park in Estacada, and the start time is still being determined. Thursday marks another busy day in Husky Athletics. The JV2 football team hosts their final game of the season, hosting the Madras White Buffaloes at home. This will also be the last game for Mr. Littman, the coach of the JV2 football team. Boys soccer will visit Estacada for their final road game. The game versus the Rangers will begin at 6. Girls soccer will be the opposite of the boys and play the home game against the Rangers, also starting at 6 under the lights on the football field. This will also be senior night for the ladies. On Friday, there is only one event going on for the Huskies, and that is the football game. They are taking a long route to Madras to face the White Buffaloes. For all of you that do not wish to travel the 4 hours, the video of the game will be streamed live with more details to come soon. On Saturday, the Huskies volleyball team will begin their postseason run with a trip most likely to Astoria to take on the 19-1 Fighting Fishermen. That's it for more upcoming events. Back to you, Cole.
Thanks, Wyatt. Well, it's that time again. Thank you for watching yet another edition of the North Marion Athletics Update. It was an exciting week at North Marion, and we enjoyed sharing the success with you. We'll see you next week with more exciting events from North Marion. Thank you.